This Master you. Yes, thy cross ever be adored. That is what we are celebrating these days, my dear brothers and sisters. And we trust that we are going to be blessed this day as they partake in the sacrifice. We ask the Lord today to accept all our intention of our people. And today is a day when we remember that the Lord is merciful to all of us. So with great trust, we present our people's intention to the Lord. Today's Mass is offered by three areas, St. Anne's, St. James, and St. Andrew. We pray for all those residing this area with our area leaders, Andrew Swami, Rani Jared, Ambrose, Pandit, Joy, and Jasmine. Then we have a thanksgiving mass in honor of the Holy Cross, offered by Patrick Benjamin and family. Thanks in the Mother Mary by Steffi Chowry. Thanks in the Holy Cross by Cecilia Philip, by Josephine Thomas, by Patrick Joseph, by Deepak Barfe, by Josie Anthony. Thanks in the Holy Spirit by Josie Anthony and family. And thanks in to Mother Mary by Nancy Xavier. Thanks in the Holy Cross by the Sebastians, Victor, Vincent, Devanason, Matthews, Alvarez, Ashwin Pawar, with our team, Lionel, Edward, Jessica, Jennifer, Simon, Purchase, and Sarah today on the keyboard. Then we also have Annie Francis, Judy, Benjamin, our CLAC team. And thanks in Mass offered in honor of the Holy Cross by Jacqueline and Rohan and John, and by Sangeeta, Aarti, Prakash, Richard, Shirish. And we pray for one of our old friend, Chitti Amma from Khadki, a woman running about house to house praying. She died last evening, and we pray that the Lord may grant her eternal rest. Then, dear friends, some of our people are admitted in hospital last night. Pray for these families. Our three families are admitted, that the Lord may touch them and that our prayers may become acceptable, that they may return home. Three families are admitted, but happy to say that three other families have returned home, having been healed in the hospital. So the Lord is teaching us that we have to continue to pray for all the sick, because they're all going to recover. Trusting that the Lord is going to do mighty works, we shall now begin with our Eucharist. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit. Humility is recognizing the truth of who we are and who God is, and living out of that truth. In order of love, the truth is that I am third, God is first, others are second, and I am third. Humbly regard others as more important than yourselves. Humility is becoming transparent so that Jesus may shine in us, even in our weakness. He must increase and I must decrease. Therefore, the cross is something wonderfully great and honorable. It is great because through the cross, the many noble acts of Christ found their consummation. Very many indeed for both his miracles and his sufferings were fully rewarded with victory. The cross is honorable because it is both the sign of God's suffering and the trophy of his victory. It stands for his suffering because on it he freely suffered unto death. But it is also his trophy because it was the means by which the devil was wounded and death conquered. The barred gates of hell was smashed, and the cross became the one common salvation of the world.
So, dear friends, the cross is calling us today to be a sign of victory, challenging us to be committed Christians. But for all those moments that we faltered and failed God in not living a full committed Christian life, let us now call to mind our sins and purify ourselves. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
People of good will, for you alone are the Holy One.
Let us pray. O God, who will that your only begotten Son should undergo the cross to save the human race, grant we pray that we who have known the mystery on earth may merit the grace of his redemption in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Malachi. And now, O priests, this command is for you. If you will not listen, if you will not lay it to heart to give glory to my name, says the Lord of hosts, then I will send the curse upon you. You have turned aside from the way. You have caused many to stumble by your instruction. You have corrupted the covenant of Levi, says the Lord of hosts. And so I make you despised and abased before all the people. Inasmuch as you have not kept my ways, but have shown partiality in your instruction. Have we not all one Father? Has not one God created us? Why then are we faithless to one another, profaning the covenant of our fathers? The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. None of us lives to himself, and none of us die to himself. If we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For this end of Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly rise for the gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus came up and said to him, Peter came up and said to him, Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? As many as 7 times? Jesus said to him, I do not say to you 7 times, but 70 times 7. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who wished to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the reckoning, one was brought to him who owed him 10,000 talents. And as he could not pay, the Lord ordered him to be sold with his wife and children and all that he had, and payment be made. So the servant fell on his knees, imploring him, Lord, have patience with me, and I will pay you everything. And out of pity for him, the Lord of the servant released him and forgave him the debt. But the same servant, as he went out, came upon another fellow servant who owed him 100 denarii. And seizing him by the throat, he said, pay what you owe. So the fellow servant fell down and besought him, have patience with me and I will pay you. He refused and went and put him in prison till he should pay the debt. When his fellow servants saw what had taken place, they were greatly distressed. And they went and reported to the Lord all that had taken place. Then the Lord commanded him and sent him, you wicked servant, I forgave you all that debt because you besought me. And should not you have mercy on your fellow servant, as I had mercy on you? And so in his anger, the Lord delivered him to the jailers till he should pay all the debt. So also my heavenly Father will do to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of the Gospel wipe away our sins.
Amen.
So my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, of what use is a candle? You light a candle, it is lit, but the brightness is not enough. Then you can't fire a candle. So also, what is the use of a Christian whose goodness does not surpass? Then we also call it a chala Christianary, which kaam ka nahi. So commitment is much more required. It is not all that you give is important. What you are not giving is much more important. You have got what you are holding on. Give a little and keep the rest. That is why St. Paul says, whether we are alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. When you are alive, you can do as much good as you can. But when you are dead, all the good that you have done is going to be repaid. So that is the commitment of a good Christian. A good Christian will never be satisfied without giving all that he has to the Lord. And the Lord, who's seeing to all the good that you're doing, is going to reward you. Especially these days, my dear friends, right from day one, pandemic, great lockdown, everything shut. People had enough with them, but they can't use it, except of what ration they had in the house, what other things they could use. You had ration, but there were people who were struggling. That is what this pandemic is teaching us. It has taught the whole world. Tere paas hai na, kitna dega dusre ko. People were struggling everywhere. Thank God, our church, through the help of Bishop's House, Bishop Dapri, even the other day he told, kisi ko kuch zarurat hai, mere paas aao. You heard what he said at the St. Ignatius Mass. He said, anybody suffering, come to me. We also asked for help and he readily gave help. We saw how Father Louis, Father Malcolm, they came in their own vehicles and brought ration and gave there. That's not the end, my friend, even today. Today, our Vincent de Paul's conference of the parish, with all of you with generous donation, today they are going to distribute food. Not food, they are going to distribute ration. And today, for the first time, they are also distributing fresh vegetables. To reach out to the needy brothers and sisters and our families in the parish. That is a commitment a Christian should have. And where God is teaching us, reminding us of a Christian commitment in this pandemic period. See how the world has reached out to so many poor people. Enough wealth in the country, but are we distributing it or keeping it for another rainy day? Now is the hour, my friend, this pandemic is teaching us to be more caring, more sharing. You cannot keep all your cupboards full of clothes without giving it to those who are in need. That is not a good committed Christian life. The Lord says, if you have got two tunics, give away one. You got two shirts, give away the one. You got two good pair of props, give away one. There are so many people who are in need. That is what this pandemic has taught a lot of things. Not to keep on holding on for ourselves. Where are we going to use this? That is the Christian life. A light is given to you, and Jesus says, you are that light. If you are the light, let this light shine wherever you walk, that the love of the Lord may be dispelled from what you are. Looking at you, they must say, ye Christian vyakti hai. Dekho kitne logon ke sahayata karte ho, ghoom raha hai. अगर ऐसे क्रिश्चियन नाम बनेंगे तो हम लाभदायक हो जाएंगे. योर कमिटमेंट इज गोइंग टू रिवॉर्ड यू. व्हेन विल दिस रिवॉर्ड कम? दैट यू डोंट डिसाइड. आई विल गेट अ रिवॉर्ड इन द इवनिंग. दैट रिवॉर्ड गॉड विल गिव यू एंड गिव यू एट द राइट टाइम. एंड व्हेन इज द लॉर्ड गोइंग टू कमिट दैट? I don't know. He's going to gather everybody at the end of time. All of you, whatever you did that to me. And having done it to me, that you did to the least of the poor of the poor, you did it to me. That is the reward. And that reward is going to be eternal life. So we ask the Lord, these days when you are believing that Jesus is died on the cross that we may be saved from our sin, that he has done. Now our commitment should be renewed. That he died, mai kuch bhi karega to chalega? No. He died once for all that your sins may be forgiven. Now is our turn. Leave all our sinfulness behind. Don't be like that man of today's gospel. Such a lot of his death has been washed away, but he catches one little fellow who has to give a few paisas. Let us not be found like that man at the end of life. Let us be generous. Let us be humble enough in the eyes of God. Share all that we have, that all that I give, much more than I have, may be a blessing for you. And may all the good that the family does be a blessing for the family. So let us all now stand. And we are now going to profess our faith in this God who loves us. We profess our faith together.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty. Creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He went down to the dead. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
We now place all our petitions in the hands of our Heavenly Father.
Let our response be, Lord, make us meek and humble of heart.
Lord, make us meek and humble of heart.
That our Pope, bishops, priests and religious may not seek their own glory, but be of service to others. Grant them the grace to be more humble, more loving and more compassionate. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, make us meek and humble of heart.
For our parents, teachers, and all those who hold responsible positions in society, that their lives be based on moral and spiritual values they impart to others. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, make us meek and humble of heart.
For all those who are overburdened and downcast, that they may be helped and supported by kind-hearted and generous people. May they experience God's love and compassion. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, make us meek and humble of heart.
Yes, Heavenly Father, we now place ourselves and our families into your hands. Make all of us generous with what we have and make us live a full, committed Christian life. We make our prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Amen. May this oblation, O Lord, which on the altar of the cross cancel the offense of the whole world, cleanse us, we pray, from all our sins. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. He death and washed away our sins, and his resurrection had purchased our justification. And so with all the angels we praise you, and with joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the gifts we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them that have you fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் நாங்கள் ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் இயேசுவே உடலே ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் நாங்கள் ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் இயேசுவே உடலே ஆராதிக்கின்றோம்
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் நாங்கள் ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் இயேசுவே ரத்தத்தை ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் நாங்கள் ஆராதிக்கின்றோம் இயேசுவே ரத்தத்தை ஆராதிக்கின்றோம்
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, a blessed Joseph, our spouse, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. May we merit to be co-heirs with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. இவரோடு இவர் எல்லாம் வல்ல இறைவனாகிய தந்தையே தூயாவினை கேட்டு எல்லாம் புகழும் மாட்சியும் என்றென்றும் உமக்கு உரியதே
ஆமென்
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that with the help of your mercy, we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with,
you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above everything, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart, as though you were already come. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Allow me not to be separated from you. Jesus, my good, my sweet and only love, inflame this heart of mine, that it may be always on fire for you.
Communion antiphon. When I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw everyone to myself, says the Lord. Let us pray. Having been nourished by your holy banquet, we beseech Lord Jesus Christ to bring those you have redeemed by the wood of your life-giving cross to the glory of the resurrection, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May Almighty God, who always keep every adversity far from you, and in his kindness pour out upon you the gift of his blessing.
Amen.
May God keep your hearts attentive to his words, that you may be filled with everlasting gladness.
Amen.
And so May you always understand what is right and good, and be found everlasting, ever hastening along the path of God's commands, ever coheres with the citizenships of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon all of you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
So, dear friends, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yes, my dear friends, who can stand when Jesus is with us? I wish you Jesus and carry Jesus with you wherever you go. And let Jesus be a sign of victory and redemption for us. This is what we are going to celebrate tomorrow. Tomorrow, once again, we'll be reaching out to you online. At 6 in the evening, your solemn mass, solemn is all by myself. I don't want to invite other priests because we are all not keeping well in our parish. So, it is going to be wonderful because tomorrow evening we are going to join with two areas, that is St. William Nagar and St. Thomas. William Nagar, Peter Shingar is our leader, and St. Thomas, we got Louis Saddam, and also Lourdes. With them, we have got St. Vincent de Paul Conference, we are the Swartha Group, we are the Catholic Association Dapodi, we got our Sunday school teachers, we got the parish council members. These will all will invite their own area people. The whole parish should invite all those who are residing in their area to join in for Mass. You don't have to come here, okay? We at home, no gathering in the church. But church will be kept open for all those who want to come and pray, not in big groups, by your family. Come and spend time keeping yourself before Jesus. Jesus is always there. You're welcome to spend time with Jesus, and maybe I can give you communion if you come in small groups. That is going to be tomorrow. Tell all your friends to join in at the Mass at that time. And then, feast celebration should be within your families. Don't call other families to join you. not this pandemic time. Pandemic time, only family is important. And so join with all your family members, have a good celebration in the house. Send little food if you can to any of the poor people that you see around walking about in Dhapuri. But don't go and spend time with them. That will be tomorrow. Feast we will definitely celebrate in God's time. All the feasts will put together and we'll have a big celebration. Today I'd like to thank the Vincent de Paul Conference and all those people who gave whatever donation they want to make their families to have a better feast celebration. And thank Vincent de Paul Conference members for taking the trouble of distributing ration to the needy of the parish. So that is for tomorrow and today. Then on Tuesday we are celebrating the feast of Our Lady of Sorrows that comes with the Holy Cross feast, Our Lady Dukkhit Mata, Vyakula Mata. And we promise to reach out to you every day. Every day in the evening, our team will reach out to you with the Holy Eucharist online. Pray for our team members. They require your prayer because Lionel has started his classes online and our Edward has to appear for his exams. Lucky we have passed all those ages. Anyway, I thank you for all that you are in the parish. You have been wonderful people. You are not coming to the church at all. But they say church is going to open. So we have to plan out how you are going to come and pray in the church. But they say small children are not allowed. So also senior citizens, more than 60, anybody of that age, they mustn't come. Don't come with a group. We'll arrange a mass for you at that time. If those 60 saal ke ho gaye na, bilkul group ke saath church mein aane ka nahi. Now be careful. You have to wear a mask. No kerchief, no pallu and all other things. If you're not wearing mask, they're going to find you. You got a lot of money. Every time they catch you, pay 500. So don't forget, buy a mask and wear the mask. No other thing is going to help you. We must comply with what our leaders are saying. Keep the distance if you come to church also. Don't stick to each other like a family you do. But you have to keep the distance even when you come to the church. But that is, we'll let you know more about it. Right now, enjoy the moment of the day. The Lord is with us. The cross of salvation is going to give us victory and redemption. God bless you all. Have a nice Sunday. But don't forget, tomorrow, get ready with your family. Fully, neatly dressed. Nobody should sit with a lungi or pajamas. Everybody should be neatly dressed for every mass that we say. Not only feast day mass. Mass is mass. We should take part neatly dressed. Home is clean. Samrani, everything should be good. Thank you for being good to us. We pray for you and you take care. Thank you.
Novena to the Holy Cross. We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee. For by thy Holy Cross thou hast redeemed the world. Jesus, who because of thy burning love for us, will to be crucified and to shed thy most precious blood for the redemption and salvation of our souls. Look down upon us and grant the petition we humbly ask for. Our prayer intention here. Altogether, Lord, we trust completely in thy mercy. Cleanse us from sin by thy grace. Sanctify our work. give us and all those who are dear to us our daily bread. Lighten the burden of our sufferings. Bless our families and grant to the nations so sorely afflicted thy peace, which is the only true peace, so that by obeying thy commandments we may come at last to the glory of heaven. Amen. Litany of the Holy Cross. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God the Holy Ghost,
have mercy on us.
Holy Cross, whereon the Lamb of God was offered for the sins of the world,
deliver us and save us.
Hope of Christians,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Pledge of the resurrection from the dead,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Shelter of persecuted innocence,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Guide of the blind,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Way of those who have gone astray,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Staff of the lame,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Consolation of the poor,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Restraint of the powerful,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Destruction of the proud,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Refuge of sinners,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Trophy of victory over hell,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Terror of demons,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Mistress of youth,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Succor of the distressed,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Hope of the hopeless,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Star of the mariner,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Harbor of the wrecked,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Rampart of the besieged,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Father of orphans,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Defense of widows,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Counsel of the just,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Judge of the wicked,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Rest of the afflicted,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Safeguard of childhood,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Strength of manhood,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Last hope of the aged,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Light of those who sit in darkness,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Splendor of kings,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Civilizer of the world,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Buckler impenetrable,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Wisdom of the foolish,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Liberty of slaves,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Knowledge of the ignorant,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Sure rule of life,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Heralded by prophets,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Preached by apostles,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Glory of martyrs,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Study of anchorets,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Chastity of virgins,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Joy of priests,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Foundation of the church,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Salvation of the world,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Destruction of the idolatry,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Stumbling block of the Jews,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Condemnation of the ungodly,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Support of the weak,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Medicine of the sick,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Health of the lepers,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Strength of the paralytic,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Bread of the hungry,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Fountain of those that thirst,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Clothing of the naked,
save us, O Holy Cross.
Lamb of God, who was offered on the cross for the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who was offered on the cross for the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who was offered on the cross for the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee,
because through thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world.
Let us pray. O God, who for the redemption of the world was pleased to be born in a stable and to die upon a cross, O Lord Jesus Christ, by thy holy sufferings, which we, thy unworthy servants, devoutly call to mind, by thy holy cross and by thy holy passion and death, deliver us from the pains of hell, and vouchsafe to conduct us whither thou didst conduct the thief who was crucified with thee, who livest and reignest eternally in heaven. Amen. Prayer for protection against coronavirus. O God, in this time of the coronavirus, we turn to you in trust and hope. You are ever full of mercy, compassion, and love towards us. We ask you, loving Father, to be merciful to us, and in your divine power, take away from all over the world this grievous pandemic of coronavirus. Inspire all authorities to take effective measures to contain the disease. Help us to be alert and vigilant against coronavirus and to follow all guidelines and directives. You redeemed and saved us through the suffering and resurrection of Jesus. Help us not be discouraged, but to believe and hope that you will bring good out of this evil. Father, let your victory and glory shine through this deadly disease, through Christ our Lord. Amen.